Hi everyone, I have an iPad in here. This is iPad A5. It has a camera problem. Phone camera is not working. This video, I mainly make it for the people who want to learn repair iPhone motherboard or iPad. iPhone and iPad, they work the same. So first I'll show you the symptoms. This is the camera behind. If I go to front, it is all blank. A front camera is not working at all, and I also have a rectangle here. There's a message. It says flash is disabled. Okay. So this is all the symptoms that normally people can get, but we are the professional. We get more than that. So when you have this problem, how do we troubleshoot? By the way, the board has been repaired before. That's why there's a mess. So when you have a camera problem, the first thing you need to tell is it the camera itself is the problem or is it the motherboard? In order to troubleshoot, is it the camera problem or motherboard or maybe the software is easy. The first one, camera, you can bring this camera to another iPad. If it is working, for sure is your motherboard or maybe the software, iOS is the problem. But the iOS will not affect the camera not working. So we were only left to one problem, which is the motherboard. When we talk about motherboard, from here, there's a flex solder on the motherboard before he's going to the camera. So which means you also need to suspect maybe this flex has a problem. So this one is really easy. You can just unplug the camera, measure every resistance of here, and then match to here. Are they well connected? By using the multimeter, you can measure line by line, or you can just replace this. So in my case, the flex itself has no problem. Then what's left is the motherboard. Some of the beginner, they might have learned it before. Right? Maybe you can measure the resistance value through the multimeter. Just check the value, which one is missing, and then you fix that. Now, there is a lot of measurement technique you need to learn. Okay? In some condition, some lines cannot be measured in a normal method, especially when you have some lines that are OL, which means no reading at all, no response. So you need to have another way to measure it further. So this is why my online course, especially the semester one, I have taught a lot of basic in what kind of condition we can measure and what kind of condition we cannot trust the reading. Okay, how do we check it further? How do we confirm every line? Are they working? And the requirement, the symptoms, many things from the basic. If your basic is strong, you can do a lot of things, even a complicated repair like this. So why I say it is a complicated repair? Okay, let me show you. It is because iPad A5, even though I have a schematic from the ZXW, the software, or even the Xingzhizhao. Okay, this brand, Xingzhizhao, Wuxingji, Lanlui, JC. I have all the schematic drawing software. So, if I look at the ZXW, this is where the flex solder on. You see every line, they have no name at all. You don't know what are they doing. You know where they go. Right? He's going to here. But you never know what is the function. So this is why I say the repair is complicated. Let me show you in the Xingzhizhao. You see, it is the same. They only show you where to go, but not to tell you what's the name of it. Why is that? It is because not every models, especially the new model, they do have the Apple schematic. You know Apple schematic for every models, they are confidential, private, secret. You cannot get them easily unless someone inside they leak it to you. Once they have the file, I mean those guys who make this kind of software, they have the file, they will upload every circuit name, the label of every circuit into their software. In here, your second question it would be, then how the hell he know which line go to which line? They have this, the whole mapping. Why they have it? It is because, don't forget, the board, PCB board, still need to be manufactured from China. the motherboard layer. That's why they do have this layout of the board, but they don't know what component is that. They just know this connection go to here, that's it. This is why there are many companies who are able to provide this kind of schematic. So I believe you understand what I'm saying, so I'm not going to explain further. So just because I don't know which line is doing what, I got no choice but to measure the things based on my experience. So let's say this one, front camera is not working. First, I need to tell the camera circuit which one is the problem. When we talk about the camera circuit, the camera lines that end up to the connector here. Let me show you. I need to disconnect the iPad first. Disconnect the power, prevent the short. Here's the front camera. This is where he connected. Of course, the basic thing is to make sure the connector is well soldered, the condition of it is perfect, and then you measure every line to get the value. Because this is from the flex, that's why in the ZXW schematic software, they don't share the resistance value. I have to do my own. Also, there's a difference between the SIM card version and the Wi-Fi version of the iPad AFI. The reading of here will be the same, but the line of here, they are different. Okay. So when I have this kind of case, camera is not working, and we are sure it is from the motherboard, we need to tell from the symptoms. We still need to get more symptoms. I'm putting everything back, I'll show you how to get further symptoms. So, as you can see, camera still the same. If I use the rear camera, it is working well. But the front is not working and it has shown us this message. I'm going to collect one more symptom, which is from the computer. I'm going to plug it in. So as we can see, iPad AF5, the first thing I want to collect is here, verification report. I'm going to look at here, front camera. He's not giving me the serial number, but the rear cam, they do have it, which means the CPU is not getting a response from the camera. They couldn't obtain the serial number. But I told you, we already tested the camera to another iPad, or maybe just bring another camera to here, it's still the same. Okay. Remember what I say, CPU is not reading the camera. And if you have been to my course, or maybe someone else, you know, the serial number, this kind of stuff, they are using the I2C connection. So this is the point I don't suspect. Is it the voltage problem or data transfer problem? And I straight will suspect it is the I2C problem, because only I2C carry the serial number. So if I'm sure the I2C isn't working, then I'm going to check which line is belong to I2C without the help from the software, because you don't know which one. So this is where I do the hard work. I already done measure the flex from the camera connector one by one, which one go to where, and then I end up with this thing. Maybe some of you are facing the same problem, so this might be useful to you. This is the front camera connector, all the value I get. How do I know which pair? I2C, they are run in pair, okay, the data and the clock. I believe some of the audience there already know it. I'm not going to explain too much I2C thing in here. This is not too technical video. If you want to learn further, you should join a course or maybe my online course. I already have a full explanation in there and what kind of symptom, behavior they have, blah, blah, blah. So I look at the value of here, then I already know which one is the I2C. Okay? That easy. Because in my course, I also have teach the measurement technique. Okay, one of it is called resistance logic. What resistance should be 300, 400, 500, maybe short, half shot. This is also in the basic, semester 1. In semester 2, I teach it further how do we analyze a complicated problem. Having a resistance value doesn't mean it is good. So anyway, I'm going straight to show you the answer. From here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This one is the I2C. Remember, this iPad A5 is the Wi-Fi version. Okay, it will be different. You see, in ZXW, they only have one model. Be careful. In this, we have two models. Xingzizao is the upper hand. They have shown Wi-Fi PCB and 5G PCB. Okay, there's a model is running SIM card. They will have a different layout. So here is the one 5G. You see the connection is behind the board. From the front, because there's no space, there's nothing to solder on here. That's why I say the layout is different. You cannot use my reading if you are fixing a different version. Anyway, let's continue about the I2C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this one, and then this one. Also, look at the layout. I prefer the ZXW. So this one and this one. See, there's a component here. Should be the resistor. So by looking at the resistor other side, you will see he is leading to somewhere. But strange, it's not straight to the CPU. It is going to here, one of the components in here. So as you can see here, it's highlighted and he is going to somewhere. Right? There's a component in here. The other side should be the major power. Okay, you see many things from this resistor highlighted. By the layout, I already know this is the power line. I should say it is the resistor for pull-up. It's giving the 1.8 power and then straight back to this component. And this component, I believe one of the dots, it is going to the CPU, but he's going out here first. Yes, there's a CPU highlighted. Anyway, I cut it short. I don't want to explain how I find out this. I will straight give you my answer, my measurement. I already save it here. I click this, you will see I have measured camera line and then how they come and go. Okay, the voltage is mean. Pull up voltage. So this line is critical. And also this line straight to the CPU is coming from this guy. And this line is from the camera. We're back to here. See? If your basic is strong, you should understand how it works. So now continue the repair. I will just disconnect the power and take out the screen. When I'm making this video, actually I already have found the problem. Actually it takes longer than that. Okay, what I'm looking at now is the flags of here. I told you already there's a number 6 dot from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and here they are going to the component of here. Okay, just because this IC is broken, so this is why the I2C is not working. And you will see there's two wire in here which I already have disconnect. Now I make it back. I'm gonna connect back my jumper. I'm bypassing this component. So this resistor before he enter to this IC, and the resistor of this side actually is coming out from this IC. And this one is easier. I will just solder like this way. Okay, because this dot is going to inside this IC and he's going out to CPU. So let me explain this way. Just look at my arrow here. The jumper I made is here to here. Straight, you bring the camera connection to the CPU. beware, not from here. Okay? It's totally different. That one is the voltage line. He's lowering the voltage to the I2C. If you know the basic of I2C, how it works, you will understand why he needs the pull up. So for anyone who have lost this component or maybe a broken, you can jump like me. So let me prove it to you. It is working. So here's the exciting moment. Open the camera. This is camera from behind. Turn on the front. Ta-da! See, the front camera is working. Hello there. Yep, that's how to repair. So, as you can learn, this can be accomplished by basic skill. You don't even use the oscilloscope to do this. Do you know that I can even twist the video, how I repair this thing? I can just show off how I'm going to use the oscilloscope. Measure the I2C line and tell, it is not working. I make this jump to there, but without any explanation. How I begin, where to check from, how do I collect a symptom. Straight, I give you the solution and show off the oscilloscope. I'm sure I can attract a lot of students in that way. But to be honest, I don't need to do that. Because most of the students that have joined my course, even for they say they have experience, they have learned to somewhere else, their basic is weak. They always imagine how is the lesson. They always think, I just need to learn this in order to fix that. But they never know what they have missed. Anyway, the point of this video is just to tell you, do not imagine how the teacher teach you the things. Maybe some teacher that do have a well-built structure, program to let you absorb a proper SOP, a proper procedure of how to repair a thing. It is best not look for those direct solution. Okay? Something like 100% solution, bro. So I guess that's it for the video and I see you on the next lesson. Bye. Okay.